And I pray that grace of the Lord will continue to be with us in the mighty name of Jesus. Without wasting much of our time, let us continue the move from where we stopped in the last time we met. And if you can recall vividly on how we begin this subject matter, and I title it the manifesting the God in you. Manifesting the God in you. So today we are talking about the series 2. That is manifesting the small letter G, God, in you. There is difference between manifesting the God, capital letter G, in you, and manifesting the God, the small letter G, that is in you. As a son, you manifest the capital letter G, God, that is in you. Why, as a man, you manifest the small letter G, God, that is in you. That is, there are two capacities that God really wants us to manifest to our generation. And the Bible said in the book of Psalm, chapter 82, verse 6, it revealed these two dimensions. He said, don't you know that you are God? And you are a children of the Most High. I told you about Shanda Lagada. Know that two statements. He said, don't you know that you are God, small letter G, at the same time you are a children of the Most High. There are differences between being a God at the same time being the children of the Most High. The moment you are born on earth, you are a son, you are a God. And until you are born again, you are not yet a son. So to be born on earth make you a God. Why to be born again make you a son? There are two dimensional revelational aspects of God that he wants us to know. But we only focus on one dimension, and that is why we are only manifesting the dimension of God we know. We fail to tap into the reality of the second dimension of God, and he wants us to also manifest that dimension, which I want to talk about. Because the revelational aspect of God you know determines the manifestation of God that you will reveal to your generation. That is, it is the God you know that men will know through you. You cannot manifest to your generation the dimension of God that you did not know. Any dimension of God that the generation is not seeing through you is the dimension of God that you have not yet known. Get this. Well, I mean knowledge. I'm not talking of intellectual knowledge. And I'm not only talking of revelational knowledge, but I'm talking of experiential knowledge. That is, experiential knowledge is when revelational knowledge is mixed with encounter. When a knowledge becomes experience, it has come to a stage where revelation has mixed with encounter. That is, you know it by your spirit and you encounter it by your spirit. Another dimension of God that you are manifesting is the dimension that you know. Until you manifest the power dimension of God, you have not yet known the power dimension of God. You have been reading about it. So you saw it in the scripture. But you have not encountered that dimension. When you encounter that dimension, it manifests in you. Any dimension you encounter become a manifested experience that generation will know through you. So there is two dimensions of God that he wants us to know. That is, to know him as a God. Two, to know him as a father. Manleko shente limo koto likadaya. When you know him as a father, you become a son. And when you know him as a God, you become a God. That is small letter G. So, that you are born on earth is a sign that the potential to manifest the God aspect of you is in you. And as you are born again, it's a sign that to manifest the sonship aspect of you is in you. So the whole creation, they are waiting for the manifestation of the sons of God. Can I say this to you? Human beings are also waiting for the manifestation of the God in you. I repeat. The creation that cannot be seen physically, the whole creation, that they are not human beings, they are waiting for the manifestation of the sons in you. But human beings on this earth, they are not only waiting for the manifestation of the son in you, they are waiting for the manifestation of the God in you. Because as a son, you are the light of the world. Why, as a God, you are the salt of the earth. You can say the reason why the whole church was locked down during the pandemic and the earth did not feel the impact of the church. Why? We have been busy manifesting the sonship aspect of us, but we are not manifesting the God that is in us. And until you manifest the God that is in you, your impact will only be felt in church. Your impact will not be felt in the world. And according to the plan of God, our impact is designed to be felt both in church and in the world. Your impact is designed to be felt in the political system of this earth. Your impact is designed to be felt in the academic system of this earth. Your impact is designed to be felt in the business sector of this earth. But the question is, what I want to ask you now, what do you have to offer to the temple of this earth? What solution do you have the ability to provide to the problem of humanity aside from healing the sick and raising the dead? Because if all we know is to be healing the sick and be raising the dead, and I ask you these simple questions: will healing the sick or raising the dead solve the economical problem of this country? If you have the ability to heal the sick and raise the dead, and God now said we should go into the world and preach the gospel, is it with the ability to heal the sick and raise the dead that you will travel from your country to another country to preach the gospel? I say this to you: to travel to another country, you will need to take two flights. You need to go through aircraft. It is the God aspect of us that produce the aircraft. It is the Son aspect of us that produce the message that you want to go and preach. You don't preach the gospel as a God. You preach the gospel as a son. But the material we need to preach the gospel, you don't produce them as a son. You produce them as a God. So as a God, you are a creator. That is, you have the ability to create things that we need to fulfill the assignment of the kingdom. Get this now. This is what makes me to be afraid. I imagine the science pack everything they've created out of this earth. Do you think we can achieve the mandate of taking the gospel to the world? Because the phone in your hand was created by somebody who is not born again. The devices you are using to listen to me now was created by somebody who is not born again. Why? Those guys have the ability to manifest the God that is in them. Even though they are not born again, they don't have the ability to manifest the Son in them. So that is why when they create those things, they didn't create it in the name of God. So all the glory was not unto God. Why? They are not born again. But just imagine, I wish it is somebody that is born again that create many devices that we are using to preach the gospel. As the message is manifesting Christ, the tools is also manifesting Christ. So the purpose of this teaching is to ensure that no, you don't lose your royal priesthood as a son. But don't, because you want to make heaven, lose the creative ability that God has given to you to solve a certain dimension of problem that is on this earth. There are natural problems that God wants us to solve supernaturally. And those problems, you don't need prayer. You only need to tap into the intelligence that God has given to you and use your thinking faculty to receive a certain dimension of ideas and use it to solve the problem of humanity. Tell somebody beside you, manifest the God that is in you. As a God, you are destined with the ability to create a thing. As a God, you are destined with the ability to solve the natural problem of man. Why, as a son, you are destined with the ability to solve the spiritual problem of man. So every man on this earth has two dimensions of problem. They have natural problem and they have spiritual problem. You don't solve spiritual natural problem with your sonship ability. You solve spiritual problem with your sonship ability. And you don't solve spiritual problem with the God that is in you. You dare not try it, but you have the ability to solve the problem of mankind with the God ability that is in you. So it's not everybody that the purpose, the reason behind their poverty is demon. There are people that it is not deliverance they need to come out of poverty. They need some form of education to manifest the greatest, to manifest the divine ability that is in them so that they can use it to produce certain things that humanity needs. Because until you solve problem, you can't be rich. Success is the ability to solve the problem of humanity. So if we just focus all our assignment in raising the dead, healing the sick, I use this opportunity to tell you that the only people that will be shining is your pastor. It will not look as if they are the most favorite candidate of God. Because they are trying to build you in line with your personality dealings. Personal dealings, I mean to say it. They are trying to build you to make them, to make you to become what they became. The assignment is in the church. Your assignment may be in the politics. And if your assignment is in the politics, it is not only a pastor you should listen to. Listen to men, even though they are not born again, but they have impact in the political system of this world. Listen to Obafemi Awolowo. Listen to Barack Obama. Even though they are not born again, but as long as they have some level of impact, you have the knowledge and wisdom to get from them. I said, at times, this is me personally now. If I want to build my spirit, I listen to spiritual things, listen to men of God, listen to their messages. But if I want to build my mind, at times I sit down with secular things. I watch secular things. I listen to secular men. Because if what you are only listening to is the things of the spirit, your mind will be too narrow to understand the move of God in this season. I can't watch CCV man become carnal because I'm a spiritual man that is trying to be natural. I'm not a natural man that is trying to be spiritual. I repeat. I am not a natural man that is trying to be spiritual. I'm a spiritual man that is struggling to be natural. So if I watch CCV, I watch this with the eyes of my spirit and I get a message out of it. I can watch Nollywood film and write revelation out of it. I can listen to news and begin to get revelation from it. Because I don't watch things as a carnal man. I watch carnal things as a spiritual man. Because if you want to build your mind, you focus on things pertaining to this earth. Why, if you want to build your spirit, you focus on things pertaining to eternity. Get this. And get this. You are not designed to be spirit. You are not designed to be complete human. You are designed to be spiritual man, not spiritual being. not spirit being, I mean to say it. You are not a spirit being. You are a spiritual man. There is a difference between a spirit being and a spiritual man. A spirit being, they are the spirit without body, but a spiritual man is a spirit with a body. So the moment you are a spirit with a body, it simply means your assignment is not in the spirit. Your assignment is in the physical. And if care is not taken, if you don't know that your assignment is on this earth, you may end up becoming heavenly conscious, you may end up becoming spiritually conscious, and become earthly irrelevant. Because you fail to know that the purpose of being spiritual is not to stay in the spirit. The purpose of being spiritual is to use spiritual ability, to use spiritual power, to use spiritual wisdom, to manifest the God and sonship dimension of you on this earth. So get this wisdom now. If you want to build your sonship, focus on your spiritual life. If you want to build your God, the God in you, focus on your mind. Build your mind. One, build your spirit. Two, and build your brain. You fill your spirit with revelation. You fill your mind with wisdom. And you fill your brain with knowledge. I repeat. Revelation state, dwell in your spirit. Wisdom dwell in your mind. Why knowledge dwell in your brain? That is, the house of revelation is your spirit. The house of wisdom is your mind. Why the house of knowledge is your brain? So brain is to knowledge, mind is to wisdom. Why revelation is to spirit? And get this now. If you want to build your son, it is by revelation and knowledge. That is, when you are getting revelation that are spiritual, when you are getting revelation that are eternal, when you are getting revelation that have to do with the reality of the things of the spirit, our spirit is being ruled, our spirit is being controlled, you are building the son aspect of you, because your sonship aspect of you belongs to the spiritual realm. You are son because you are alive in the spirit. You have a life in the spiritual world. So, just as you have a life in the spiritual world, you also have a life in this material world. A material world is into two realms. We have the earth realm, we have the world. I repeat. The material world is in two realms. We have the earth, we have the world. The invisible realm is of two realms. We have the spiritual realm and we have the supernatural realm. Just pay attention and we explain it. So we are talking about four realms now. The spiritual realm, the supernatural realm, the earthly realm, and the world. So, the invisible realm is of two realms, the spiritual and the supernatural. The visible realm is of two realms, the earth and the world. So, you move on earth with your senses. You move on earth with your brain. But to survive and succeed in the world, you need wisdom. Katoli moshende ligada. Hey, moshende li katoli mundu ligada. I repeat, let me give you a practical example. If you want to cross an express and a car is coming, how do you know you need to wait for that car to pass? It's just your brain, common sense. So if you are talking to someone, what makes you to be talking to the person and you are not talking to God? Common sense. So the purpose of brain is to know common things, to move on it. But when it comes to the table of the things that matters, business world, political world, you don't talk there with your brain, you talk there with your mind. That is, when your world is not communicating value, when your world is not communicating impact, when your world is not producing results, it's not solving problems, you can never be a man of value. So that you know how to speak English doesn't make you to be matter in the things pertaining to this world. So what men want to see you doing is not the ability to speak good English. You speak good English with your intelligence. And that's why you see a governor who can speak good English, but after 4 years, he has behaved foolishly. Because he's an educated fool. He has something in his brain, he don't have something in his mind.
His brain is full, but his mind is empty. And you don't rule this earth with brain. When you put a man who have academic intelligence, you put him to be a leader of any political party, I use this opportunity to tell you that you have just put a disaster in that political party. That is just the atomic bomb that we should be expecting. Disaster that we should be expecting. Because you don't rule the world system. You don't rule system with academic intelligence. You rule system with wisdom. He said, woe unto a man whom a child, whom a king is a child. The word child is not baby. It's talking about somebody without wisdom. Somebody that have the ability, that have no ability to produce a decision that will solve the problem of humanity. So to handle common things, you need knowledge. But to undo things that pertain to man, the moment two people are coming together for a certain purpose, knowledge is not enough. You need wisdom. That's why the Bible says, by wisdom, a home is built. That means you don't build your marriage because you're academically intelligent. There are many people who are academically intelligent, but their marriage is doomed. Why? They have knowledge, they don't have wisdom. Because if you want to know a man that has something upstairs, they can speak good English. But put them in a matter that have to do with responsible things. And there is an adage that said, no man is responsible until responsibility is given to him to key. Until you have been given a seat of responsibility. That is when we will know whether you are a man of wisdom or all you know is just to know how to speak English. So you can see why somebody will come out with first class and at the end of the day, ask him what is next about his life. He has nothing to offer. Why? Simply because he has something upstairs, but when it comes to things pertaining to life, wisdom is missing. Because wisdom has to do with how to handle life matters, how to handle situations, how to handle things pertaining to this life. So knowledge is about oratory. Knowledge is about, you can explain. But wisdom has to do with action. It's practical. So you rule the world not with knowledge but with wisdom. Most of those that are manifesting, that are succeeding in the business world, most of them are not too academically intelligent, but there is a wisdom sitting in their mind. They know what you don't know. That's why they are succeeding. At least we know Bill Gates. It's one of the examples. We are talking of wisdom, ability to produce something out of what you see in the environment. A man that have knowledge will get to a place and see problem, but a man that have wisdom will get to a place and see opportunities. So you move on earth with common sense, knowledge, but you move in the world with wisdom. So men that manifest wisdom, they are the one ruling the earth. That's what the Bible says. Wisdom is the principal thing. When it comes to things pertaining to this earth, wisdom is the principal thing. When it comes to things pertaining to the spirit, revelation is the principal thing. I repeat. When it comes to things pertaining to this earth, wisdom is the principal thing. Why? When it comes to things pertaining to the spirit, revelation is the principal thing. As a son, revelation is the principal thing. Why? As a God, small letter G, wisdom is the principal thing. So if you have revelation without wisdom, you will only be useful in the church. You'll be good as a chief usher. But to rule in the affairs of this earth, you must be able to manifest the God aspect of you. And that is why Jesus said, he said, everything pertaining to life and godliness has been given to you. Pertaining to godliness, revelation. Pertaining to life, wisdom. That is, everything pertaining to life is gotten by wisdom. Everything pertaining to godliness is gotten by revelation. Your righteousness is not gotten by what you do. It's gotten by revelation. It is a righteousness that you know by faith. So you are righteous not because you do anything. You are righteous because you believe. And the end point of every faith is revelation. That is the source of every faith, I mean to say, is revelation. So in the physical, we have earthly realm, where you move with knowledge, common sense. The moment common sense is out of you, the next thing is madness. So the opposite of common sense is madness. So that's why when you see people who are mad, who are insane, you see the way they are doing on it. So when somebody is sane, is in his right sense, he moves on earth as a normal man. That is, they don't see you as a madman. But you can be moving on earth as a normal man and be foolish. So that's for you to know that knowledge is not enough. So you can talk in, put on correction, put on tie, and still be foolish. Because foolishness is not in the way you dress. Foolishness is not in the way you talk. But foolishness is in the way you act. That is, things you do day to day that get results for you. Now, but when it comes to teaching of the spirit, it's also in two realms. I said, in the supernatural and in the spiritual. You enter into the supernatural by vision. You enter into the spiritual by revelation. So just as knowledge and wisdom is in the physical, is in the visible realm, so also revelation and vision govern the spiritual realm. Govern the invisible realm, I mean to say it. Because we have two realms, the visible realm and the invisible. Then the visible realm is concerned with the earth and the world. And if you listen to my series one, I explain the difference between the earth and the world. That is, the earth is comprised of the things God created. So the earth is governed by, as on earth, you have everything created by God. And the law that governs the earth system is called natural law. But when it comes to the world is controlled by a system. So natural law doesn't function in the world system. There is a certain dimension of wisdom laws that rule the world system. If you don't tap into that law, you can never rule in the world system. And manifested, and when wisdom is released, it's called law and principles. So the principle that govern earthly realm is different from the principle that govern the world system. The principle that govern earthly realm is called natural law. And as a common sense, you use common sense to obey natural law. So you follow natural law with your common sense. So we call it natural wisdom. But when it comes to the world system, there is a certain dimension of wisdom that rules that dimension. And that system, that wisdom is higher than natural law. Is it that you have the ability to tap into a divine wisdom or wisdom that is not common to rule the world system? So men that rule the world system, they are men that have the ability to tap into the wisdom that goes beyond natural. So some join Illuminati to get a wisdom that goes beyond natural, while some of us who are born again, we tap into the spirit to receive a wisdom that goes beyond natural. Lest you will not have the ability to produce something in the table of the world system. So on the visible aspect of the earth and the world. On the invisible aspect, on the visible aspect, we have the natural, the supernatural, and the spiritual. There is a difference between the supernatural and the spiritual. Let me explain it. You enter into the supernatural by three realm, by three methods. Pay attention. You enter into the supernatural, one, by dream. Two, by imagination. And three, by vision. The supernatural realm is a realm that are governed with signs, with image, but those images, they cannot be seen with your physical eyes. So, but in the supernatural realm, you don't know, you see. In the spiritual realm, you don't see, you know. The spiritual realm is not governed by image, it's governed by light. The supernatural realm is not governed by light alone, it's governed by image. That is, things you see. You may just say, I see a monkey, I see a demon, I see. At the time you are seeing what others are not seeing, you are out of a natural, you are in the supernatural. At the time you are knowing what others are not knowing, you are not in the supernatural, you are in the spiritual. So, spiritual realm is a realm where you know. How you know, you can't explain. You just know, you know. That is the realm Adam was operating from. When you just look at Eve and say, this is the bone of my bone. And it was taken from my flesh. The question is, how does he know that Eve was his bone on his bone? He didn't hear any voice. Because in the spiritual realm, you don't hear voice. You just know. The eyes of your understanding is opened. That's what Paul was saying. He said, I pray that the spirit of wisdom and revelation will rest upon you so that the eyes of your understanding will be open. In the supernatural, the eyes of your soul open and you see. But in the spiritual, the eyes of your understanding is the one that has been anointed to open and you begin to know. So when the eyes of your soul is open, you see. When the eyes of your understanding is open, you know. Katoli Moshandaya. Ephesians chapter 1, verse 17. Paul began to pray for the church of the Ephesians. He said, I pray that the eyes of your understanding will be enlightened. The next thing he said, so that you may know. Katoli Moshandaya. The hope of the glory. He didn't say so that you may see. So when the eyes of your understanding opened, you don't see, you know. How you know, you can't explain, but you just know, you know. That realm is the realm of only those who are born again. Anybody that is not born again have the ability to travel into the supernatural world. The children of darkness can travel into the supernatural world, but until you are born again, you cannot travel into the spiritual realm. The spiritual realm is not even for the realm of angels. Angels stop in the supernatural. Both the angels of darkness and the angel of light, both of them are in the supernatural, because the supernatural realm is of two. We have the kingdom of darkness, we have the kingdom of light in the supernatural realm. But in the spiritual realm is the realm of the Father, sons, and the Holy Spirit, and we the children. So if you are not a son, if you have not been born by the Spirit, you cannot enter into the spiritual realm. If you are created by the Spirit and you don't have a body, you stay in the supernatural realm. But the moment you are born by the Spirit, you move out of the supernatural realm and stay in the spiritual realm. There is difference between being created and by the Spirit and being born by the Spirit. Angels are not born by the Spirit. They are created by the Spirit of God. I repeat. Angels are not born by the Spirit of God. They are created by the Spirit of God. But we are not only created by the Spirit, we are born by the Spirit. So, and for those who are born by the Spirit, they are the son. Angels are not sons of God. Katoli Moshende Digada. I repeat, angels, they are not biological. Can I use biological? let me just say that they are not biological, because when I say they are not sons of God, your intelligence may quickly go to the book of Job, where the Bible says that the children of God gathers and devil was with them, and think the Bible is talking about angels. But I say this to you, angels are not born. The word son means to be born, but angels are only created. They are not born, they are not sons of God. So you will advise you to begin to make research and know the Greek and Hebrew meaning of that statement. So, and when you are created, the highest realm you can get to is to be an adopted son. So if eventually angels are sons, it means we can say they are adopted sons, but they are not direct sons of God. So that is why angels cannot enter into the spiritual realm. Angels can only stop at the supernatural. And when they stay in the supernatural, you see them bow down saying, holy, holy, holy unto your name. Because they cannot go beyond them. Because to them, God dwells in an unquenchable light. And that realm called unquenchable light is called spiritual realm. And in the spiritual realm, that realm is a realm that is full of revelation. That is why there are things that we, the sons of God, know that angels did not know. you may confirm that in the book of Ephesians chapter 1, chapter 3, verses 13. The Bible says the manifold wisdom of God will be made manifest by the church, so that the principalities and the angels can learn the things of the Spirit from the church. Can I say this to you? As I'm talking to you now, there are eight demons that are listening to me. They are learning. Not they are spying, they are learning. Angels are also listening. They are learning. The cloud of weakness that the book of Hebrews talk about, they are also learning. Because the Bible says we are surrounded by the cloud of weakness. Elisha, Moses, and every one of them. Because we know more than them. Elijah may be powerful more than you, but you are wise than him. Because the Bible said the least in the kingdom will be greater than what? Than John the Baptist. The least in the kingdom. And among the Old Testament prophets, the highest man is John the Baptist. Did John the Baptist raise the dead? No. Did John the Baptist heal the sick? No. For you to know that power is not the man, is not the evidence, is not a criteria to know the highest in the realm of the Spirit. So the way you manifest power on earth is not a criteria to know the highest man in the realm of the Spirit. When it comes to the manifestation of power, John was the least. But the Bible says John is the what? He's the greatest. So don't think a man of God is operating in power and think he's the greatest in the spirit. No. Power is not a tool to measure the greatest in the spirit. Wisdom is the tools. Revelation is the truth. John is the one that have the ability to know Christ by revelation. John is the first man to begin to operate in revelation. So the cloud of weakness, the Bible says we are surrounded. What the cloud of weakness they are doing is that they are jotting, they are listening to what we are saying. There are things that Moses did not know that is learning from us. There are things that Elisha did not know, they are learning it from us. Because the church has been ordained to reveal the manifold wisdom of God. And there is a realm where wisdom, where revelation is released, and that realm is called the spiritual realm. In the supernatural realm, you see vision. In the supernatural realm, you can enter there by dream. When you sleep in the night, your soul can rise up and begin to move in the supernatural realm. At times, if you are good in using your imagination, you can enter into supernatural with your imagination. But where you there is a realm you can stop through imagination. There is a realm you can stop through dream. Why the highest realm you can get to is through vision. Either through trance or through vision. Because the supernatural realm is in Kedas. The least realm in the supernatural realm is called the imaginational realm. You enter there through imagination. And the second realm that is higher than the realm of imagination is through dream. You can enter into the supernatural through dreams. And you can have a encounter with the things of the spirit through dream. And the highest realm is through vision of the supernatural realm. But when it comes to spiritual realm, it is by revelation. And when revelation is being manifested, you don't see, you don't say you know. You don't even hear voice in the supernatural. A light appear and you begin to know. How you know, you cannot explain. So to manifest the God aspect of you, build your mind with wisdom, build your brain with knowledge. Why to manifest the Son aspect of you, you build your mind, you build your spirit with vision and build it with revelation. Because the Bible said in the last day, he said, I will pour out my spirit and the Son, not the God, the Son shall what? Shall see vision. So as a son, you have the ability to move in the realm of vision. You also have the ability to move in the realm of revelation. Why as a God, you have the ability to manifest the wisdom aspect of God. You also have the ability to manifest the knowledge aspect of God. So you move on earth with knowledge. You move on the world with wisdom. You move in the supernatural realm with vision. And you move in the spiritual realm with revelation. And I pray God will bless you in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen.